So reaching the crown of the head up to the sky. Take your chin slightly in towards your chest. Feel the lengthening in the back of the neck. And today we're going to take a power mudra. So that's a hand gesture which helps to energize us. So I'd like you to cross your fingers one over the other. Hold them tight. Press your thumbs together and take the palms of the hands to face up. So it's like a receiving cup of energy. So imagine that bowl that you're creating with your hands is receiving universal cosmic energy. Closing the eyes and drawing your focus and attention inwards. Checking in on yourself today, this morning, or whenever you're choosing to do this class. Checking in with how you feel without judgment. Just noticing how the body feels, how the mind feels, and any thoughts that arise, maybe see to let them go for now. We'll come back, you can come back to them later. Because remember that energy follows thought. So wherever your thoughts go, your energy can follow. So keeping your focus and attention on your practice, on your body, on your breath. Not trying to hook in and get ensnared by thoughts of other things that you might need to do today. Keep your thoughts on your breath if you struggle to keep focus and attention in the present moment. So becoming fully present. Life occurs in the present. Thoughts occur for the future and the past. So the past and the future are merely thoughts. Life, real life, occurs in the present moment. So focusing up on your breath, purely on your breath, is a really excellent way to make yourself feel more present in each moment. And then I encourage you to take some time to practice some gratitude. Maybe for the next 21 days or to the end of February, when you wake up in the morning, to think of maybe three things that you're grateful for. And take each day at a time and thinking those three things you're most grateful for. And if possible, each day, three different things. It only takes a couple of moments to do this. It kind of sets your intention, so to speak, with gratitude, starting your day with gratitude. Gratitude and love. Things that you love and are grateful for. Fear cannot coexist with love and gratitude. So this really helps us to reduce our fears, our anxiety, or our stresses. So make this a new practice for yourself. When you wake up, you can even jot it down, write it down. And if you have another minute or two to spare, maybe when the kettle's boiling first thing in the morning, jot those three things that you're most grateful for down. And if possible, think back in the last 24 hours of an occurrence, an event, something that happened to you that you really loved, that you felt passion, that you felt real gratitude for. Because as you recall that memory, you're bringing gratitude back into the present moment. And our mind tells us these thoughts, and then our body follows with feeling and emotion and a connection. So you tap into that positive thought, that positive gratitude, love feeling, and your body responds. So you relive that moment. So you reset your nervous system, coming out of maybe fight or flight into that glorious sympathetic nervous system. Oh, sorry, out of the sympathetic into the parasympathetic. So from fight or flight into rest, digest, and thrive. So maybe now taking yourself towards an intention for your practice, intention towards yourself, but a positive resolve. Maybe it is to make a gratitude practice. Or maybe you just want to say, I am here, I am now, I am present. but find your intention. Your energy will flow and follow towards that intention. Positive energy. Repeat it quietly to yourself. You can say it out loud if you feel comfortable doing so. Or just speak to your inner mind's eye. See it brightly, clearly, with detail, high definition. See your intention. I am. Make it positive in the present tense, the present moment. Feeling the flow of your breath now in and out through the nose. Feel the chest expand, maybe the shoulders rise and fall. Notice your breath, your life force, your energy flowing through you, flowing through your body, revitalizing you, bringing fresh new energy in. So thinking of that strong, fresh new energy, let's open our eyes and take some seated stretches now. So taking your arms to your side, palms forward, take a nice deep breath in, reach up to the sky, bring your palms of your hands together, reach up, look up to your hands. Then exhale, flow the arms down, making a steady, even breath here, counting in for four, three, two, one, reaching up. And then exhaling, reaching down, drop your chin to your chest, feel a stretch in the back of the neck. Let's do that two more times, four, three, two, one on the inhale, looking up, and then exhale, floating the arms down. Engage into your belly, draw your navel to your spine. One more, inhale, reach up. And then exhale, reaching down. Nice, steady, even breaths. Keeping your left hand down, take your elbow down towards the floor, floating the right arm over the sky, up to the sky, and then alongside your right ear. Keep your chest facing forwards, look up. Take a big breath in, and then going over to the other side. So right hand down, elbows down, reaching up and across. Keep your chest facing forwards, don't point down to the floor. Look up beyond your arm to the sky. Let's do that one more time each side. Big breath in, and then exhale, reach. Inhale to come up, floating up. Exhale over to the other side. Reach, 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 and then inhale to center. Taking your arms behind your head, big breath in, reach the elbows back, open the chest, lift your heart to the sky. Then exhale, crunch it in, bring your elbows together. It's like you're curling into an abdominal crunch. Big breath in, open up wide. Lift your gaze and heart to the sky. Exhale, crunch it in. Inhale, open up. Exhale, crunch it in. And then releasing. I'm going to take a little stretch forward. So walk your hands forwards. Spider your fingers. Just take myself a little further back. Spider your fingers. So really spread the shoulder blades wide across the back. Scoop your belly in. So begin to engage into your lower bunders. Begin to engage into the pelvic floor, the perineum area, and draw your navel to your spine. So reaching forward, take a nice deep breath in. Then exhale, drop your head down towards the earth. Let your head hang heavy. Maybe the forehead will come down to the floor. If it doesn't, don't worry. Really feel the wideness across the shoulder blades. Really slide them apart. Lovely stretch across the shoulders. Concentrate on your breath, steady and even. And then inhale over to the left, reaching your fingers as far to the left as you can, keeping your right hip grounded to the earth. Two deep breaths here, in and out. Then inhale, walking your hands to center. Let's go over to the right. Feel a lovely stretch down the side body. Two deep breaths in and out here. Inhale to center. Now, from here, grab your blocks. Two options. Hands on blocks, keeping your feet crossed. We're going to start to add in a little bit of strength and power now. Going to press your hands into the blocks or into the floor. if you have long enough arms and you have the strength to do that, do it in the floor. If not, pressing your hands into the blocks. I want you to take a nice deep breath in and then exhale, lift the hips off the floor. Squeeze your, like you're trying to bring your knees in towards your chest, draw your navel to spine. 5 breaths here. Big breath in, exhale, release down. Let's do that one more time. Give your hands a little shake out. Roll of the wrists. I'm going to be doing a little bit of work using our wrists, so make sure that you rotate them and you give them a shake out every now and then. Let's take another one of those lifts. This is a Tolasana lift, Lotus Padmasana. So it's like the other option, if you can take a full lotus. So do your lift with your legs as they were, cross-legged, or if you can take a full lotus, you can lift the legs, the hips, the buttocks off the floor for 5 breaths. Put your knees a little higher. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You should start to feel that energy moving, starting to heat up. Release the feet either from the lotus or cross-legged. We're going to come over onto our knees. Again, a couple of options here. You can press into blocks or press into the earth. Take your hands shoulder distance apart. Tuck your toes under. Your knees hip distance apart so the legs aren't together. What we're going to be doing is engaging into the abdominal area, into your pelvic floor. I'm going to be lifting the hips up to the sky. If you can, keep your feet, the tops of your feet pressing into the earth. If that feels uncomfortable for your feet, you can tuck the toes. If possible, take the feet with the tops of the feet pressing into the mat. Take your hands a little bit closer to your knees than I just showed you and lift. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. These are called turtle lifts. Give your hands a little shake out. Can do it 2 more times. Take a big breath in, lift, squeeze, navel to spine. And release down. 1 more time. Big lift, push into the hands. And then as you drop down, take a little cow position with the back, open the chest, look up. 1 more lift. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Open the chest. So you're tilting the pelvis down towards the floor. Roll the shoulders back and down. So we're curving the spine up other way, looking up, lift your chest and heart to the sky. Tuck your toes. Lift the hips up, pedal out the legs a little bit, and then walk your feet up to your hands, hip distance apart, clasp opposite elbows. Let your head hang heavy. Nod the head yes, shake the head no. Draw some circles with the nose. Big circles, releasing any tension in the neck. And then releasing your arms, allow your hands to gently graze the floor, swaying side to side. And then staying on one side, taking a little twist to the right or the left, either side doesn't matter. So the feet and legs stay static, taking a little twist in the upper body, other side. And then walking your feet up to the top of the mat. We're gonna take some sun salutations now. First, starting to engage with your feet into the earth. Really feel the feet grounded into the mat. Mountain pose. Spread your toes widely. Take the extra curve out the lower spine. Roll the shoulders back and down. Engage into the arms all the way to the fingertips. Chin slightly tucked towards the chest, so you feel that length in the back of the neck, then the crown of the head reaches up to the sky. Ujjayi breath, victorious breath, in and out through the nose. Inhale, sweep the arms wide, look up to your hands. They reach to the sky, Urdhva Hastasana. Exhale, forward fold, Swan Dive down. Plant the hands, bend the knees if you need to, but make sure you take your hands to the earth. Inhale, half lift.
So take
chin and tap the toes, like coming into little locus, the lambasana. Lift the chest, push it. Tuck to the body, skim the body above the ground. Downward facing dog, 5 breaths. Ujjayi breath, steady, even. Remaining fully present. Stay with your focus on your class, on your practice. One more deep breath in and out. Bend the knees, thighs to belly, look forwards. Exhale as you pop the knees up and then inhale. Come into that half lift. Ardha Uttanasana. Forward fold, plant the hands. Hastha Bandha. Your hands to the floor. Root the feet, keep the arms up. All the way to the top, little micro back bend if that feels good for you, if you're ready. Exhale one more time. Side to each side. Don't hold your breath. And exhale to lower the chest. Take your feet a little bit wider. Lift your left hand to your right ankle. Look up to the sky beyond your armpit. One nice big breath in and out. Bring the left hand back. And then reach the right hand to the outside of the left ankle. Lift your gaze to the sky. And then reach the right hand. Take your feet back to your down dog. Breath in, lifting the heels up, look forwards, exhale, hop step, jump up lightly. Inhale, half lift, exhale, deeply forward fold. See if you can deepen it a little bit more this time. Inhale, reaching the feet, arms up. Back down with the hands this time. Samasthiti. Close the eyes for a couple of breaths. Take a little sway from side to side, feeling your balance. The four corners of your feet, so rocking into the toes, into the heels, onto the outer blade of the right foot, the left foot. Noticing your balance points. Feeling the energy flow from your feet to it up all the way to the crown of the head, down the arms to the hands. Feel your whole body breathing. Opening the eyes now. Take Surya Namaskar, Sun Salutation. Inhale, relax together with your hands, nice and tight. Inhale, coming into chair pose, Utkatasana. Reach the arms to the sky, scoop the belly up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, half lift. Hold the breath. Shin in. Exhale, down dog. Now this time we're going to take power down dogs. Going to reach the right leg to the sky and a breath in. Look between your hands. Draw your knee in towards your nose. And then kick it back up. Plant it down. Inhale, left leg to the sky. Look between the hands. Draw your knee to nose. Back up to the sky with that left leg. Hold it here, then bend the knees a little bit, step your right foot, come into Ashtha Chandrasana. So the left heel is lifted off the floor, reaching the arms to the sky, push into the front big toe. Imagine a ball of energy spinning between your hands. Look up. Nice big breath in and out. Exhale, frame the front foot into your plank. Lower yourself down, your choice on an exhale, come into up dog, down dog, exhale. Left leg to the sky, step it forwards, keep off the heel, keep the heel lifted off the right foot, the back leg, squeeze and straighten that back leg, push into the front big toe, reaching the arms to the sky, Ashtha Chandrasana, left side, look up to that spinning ball of energy between your hands. Big breath in, exhale, frame the front foot. Into that plank. Exhale, lower down, your choice. Chaturanga, nice and strong. Hover above the floor. Inhale, up dog. Lift your heart and gaze. Exhale, navel to spine. Scoop back like you're pulling your belly towards your spine. Down dog, exhale. Three breaths this time to recover. Nice strong breaths in and out. Inhale, bend the knees, look forwards. Exhale to hop, step or jump up. Breath in, half out, exhale, forward. Utkatasana chair, squeeze the feet and legs together. It's like you're sitting on a chair, so the bottom slides back, but the chest and arm lift forward. Imagine that ball of energy between your hands. Exhale. Inhale to lift. Plant the hands, jump, step back into your plank, your choice, lowering down. On an exhale, inhale for your lifting heart and gaze up. Exhale to your down dog. Kicking the right leg to the sky. Let's take it over to the right knee. Left knee with the right leg. Kick it up. Other way. From down dog, we're doing left leg up to the sky. And then left knee to right elbow. And then kick it up to the sky. And then we're going to come into warrior one. So stepping your right foot forwards, drop the back heel at a 45 degree angle. Virabhadrasana, sorry, I've got a little blockage in my throat. Warrior one, right side. Hold the energy ball between your hands, look up. Exhale, frame the front foot into your plank, lower down. Up dog, inhale, down dog, exhale. Step your left foot forwards, drop the back heel. 45 degrees, hips are facing forwards. Straighten the back leg, bend into the left. Ball of energy between the hands. This is your warrior one, Virabhadrasana. Frame the front foot, come into your plank. Exhale, lower down. Up dog, inhale. Down dog, exhale. Three recovery breaths. Next breath in, bend the knees, thighs towards the belly, hop, step or jump up, exhaling. Half lift for your inhale, exhale for your forward fold, Uttanasana. Inhale into Utkatasana, chair pose. Scoop the belly up, exhale, forward fold. Inhale for your half lift, gaze forwards, plant the hands, hold the breath, hop, step, jump back to the last round, exhale lower. Up dog, inhale. Down dog, exhale. Lift the right leg to the sky, bend the knee. Take some big circles with the leg. One or two in each direction. And then we're going to take a big step forwards with the right foot and drop the left knee to the floor. Coming into that low crescent lunge. So sink the hips down towards the floor. Enjoy a lovely stretch into the front leg hip flexor. Inhale, reach your arms to the sky, palms and hands together. Look up. If you want to, you can untuck the back toes and squeeze into that left leg and lift the left leg so you're just on the top of the left foot. One more deep breath in. Exhale, frame the front foot. Drop the knee down. If you'd lifted it, tuck the toes into your plank on a breath in. Exhale, lower down. Keep the elbows squeezing close to the body. Inhale, your up dog and your down dog. Exhale, let's open the hip on the left side. Left leg to the sky, bend the knee. Rotate that knee. Big circles, couple of times each direction. Step forwards, left foot between the hands. Drop the back knee to untuck the toes. Deep crescent lunge. Anjaniasana. Palms the hands together. Take that squeeze of the leg to lift the back shin off the floor if you want. It's a bit of a balance. Power move here. Big breath in. Exhale, drop the knee down, tuck the back toes. Frame the front foot, inhale into your plank. Exhale, lower down. Should be feeling nice and warm now. Inhale, up dog, down dog, exhale. Now take a deep breath in and fill the lungs. Open the mouth and sigh the breath out. Two more times to do that. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, stick the tongue out too, look to the third eye. Releasing any energy that you don't need, any negativity, any darkness. Inhale, bend the knees, look forwards. Exhale, hop, step or jump up. Inhale, half lift. And then forward fold, exhale. Root the feet into your chair pose. Hands to heart center, slide the hips a little further back. Squeeze the legs together. Let's twist our chair to the right. Try to bring your hands towards your heart center and open the arms up. Padavrita Utkatasana. Hands to heart center, let's go over to the other side, hooking the right elbow across the left knee. Lift your heart towards your hand center. Open the arms. Smile on the face. Enjoy your energy. And then reach your arms forward, stretch your arms forward, squeeze the thighs together. Look down towards the floor, long, nice long neck. And then plant the hands to the floor. Take your knees down. Take a little Balasana, child's pose. Five deep breaths here. So reaching the arms away behind you. Palms of the hands facing up. Allow the shoulders to roll forwards. Big breath in. Going to take some side planks now. This is called Vasisthasana. Okay, so left knee down, right leg to the side, feet facing forwards, hands down, under left arm underneath left shoulder, reach your arm up, look up to the sky. So holding this here, or taking it a step further, where you really root the right foot in, and you bring your feet together. Stacking the feet one in front of the other or one on top of the other. Look up to your hands if you can. Two more breaths. Squeeze into the side body. Squeeze the thighs towards each other, glutes, the hips. Strong power move here. And then slowly drop the knee down. Going to the other side. Starting with the knee down, reach the arm up. So knee sort of under the hip here and your hand beneath your shoulder. So when you reach the legs together, you're nicely stacked and aligned. Look up to your top hand. Hopefully you're feeling lovely and warm by now. lots of new fresh energy flowing through your body, through your veins, through your channels in your body. Bring your feet together. Stack one in front of the other or on top of each other, your choice. Big smile. Enjoy. Squeeze the legs together, hips together. Give the hips a little lift. Look up to your top hand. Two more breaths. And slowly bringing it down. Release that down. Hands down. Tuck the toes. Walk the feet forwards. You're going to forward fold now. So feet hip distance apart. Hands fully down. Alongside, lining up with the toes. The heels of the hands lining up with the toes. Scoop the belly up. Really engage into your Uddiyana Bandha, your pelvic floor. Those two lifts there. And then drawing the belly down towards the thighs. Release the head. It's like you're trying to pull the crown of your head down towards the earth. Another four breaths. With every exhale, see if you can bring yourself further down your legs. And then keeping your feet and legs as they are, you can take a little micro bend in the legs. They don't lock the knees out. So tiny little micro bend in the knees. Take your hands behind your back, clasp the hands together, and then reaching the hands with the palms facing up towards the sky. Drawing your head down, reaching the crown of the head to the earth. Feel your feet rooted into the ground. Three more breaths. A little lower with the fold. And then release the arms down, a little bend into the legs, drawing yourself up to standing nice and close, nice and slowly, your head coming up last. Don't want to get dizzy. Bring your feet together or hip distance apart, your choice. We're going to take swaying palm tree now. Root the feet. Big toes, all the toes spread. Really feel them as though they're roots growing into the earth, drawing the energy up your legs. Take your hands together, peaceful yogi gun. So point your fingers together, then interlock the other fingers and the thumbs interlock over each other. Reach your arms to the sky. So your arms are alongside your ears. Feel as though you're reaching your fingertips up to the sky. I'm not quite fitting in the frame here, but don't worry. Inhale and then exhale. To the left. So you're sending your hips to the right, your arms to the left. Take a nice deep breath in and out. And then inhale to come to center and exhale, go over to the other side. Inhale to center. Let's do that one more each side. Inhale to center. And then reaching down. Reaching your arms up to the sky. And then taking your hips forward and your arms back. Enjoy a little back bend. So lifting your heart. And bring your hands together if that feels more comfortable. So taking a look up to the sky. And then back to Summer City, hands to heart center. Take a step back with your left foot. Going to come into triangle pose now with some slightly more powerful arm positions than normal. So feet nice and wide, front heel back in arch, arms reach out, and then reach to your right, jutting your left hip out like somebody's pulling you by the fingertips. Take your hand down towards your shin, roll your right shoulder, your left shoulder back so it stacks onto the left, so your chest is facing forward. Reach your left arm up to the sky, look up. And then taking the weight out of that right hand, lift onto your heel, and then take your hand to your heart center. So you're on the heel of your right foot. And then plant it down, and then reach your right hand forwards. And then take your arms alongside your ears. Three more breaths. Bend into the front knee and then reaching the arms to the side. pivot on your feet to the other direction. So now we're going to go towards the left. Jut the hip out to the right. Reaching your left hand, reach. So you're trying to stack your body as though you're pressing it against the wall or it's between two planes of glass. So the bottom doesn't stick out. So tuck the bottom in. Reach your right arm to the sky. Roll that right shoulder back, chest face forwards. Look up to your top hand. Lift the front toes off. Hand to heart center. Look up. Drop the front toes. Reach the left hand forwards. So what we're doing is we're engaging into our left side body. We're not dumping down into that left hand. Reach your arms alongside your ears. Three deep breaths. Feel a little shaking, a bit quivering. That's all your energy flowing, working hard. Big breath in, bend into that front leg. Reach the arms to the side. Pivot yourself round to the front of the mat. We're going to revolve our triangle now. So what we need to do is face the hips forwards and step your left foot in a little bit and to the side. So now your feet aren't quite aligned in a central line. They're a little bit further apart. Hips face forwards. So you have a 45 degree angle on that left leg. Hips face forwards. And we want to reach forwards with your left hand or your right hand on your hip. Reach forwards and then bring it down either onto a block or onto the outside of the right foot. Roll your right shoulder back, scoop the belly in, draw your left hip forwards and your right hip back. Look to your right, maybe over your shoulder. You can stay here, we can reach the right arm to the sky. Squeeze your thighs towards each other. Scoop the belly up, in and up. Two more breaths. Then looking forwards, we're going to come into Warrior C. So reach your arms to the side like you're taking like you're an aeroplane. So this is the prep. We're going to take our weight into our right foot. So reaching yourself forwards with your weight forwards, reach the arms to the side, lift the left leg to the sky towards hip height. Flex the foot, reach your arms wide, and then reach them forwards. Warrior three. Three more breaths. And then taking your hands to the floor. Lift your leg, your left leg higher, up to the sky, standing split. You can take your right hand onto your right ankle, draw your head down towards your leg. Two more breaths. And then without dropping the left foot to the earth, we're going to come up to standing without dropping the foot down. So push your right foot into the floor. Find your balance. You're going to take your left hand onto your left knee. Come up to standing. Oops, drop down with the foot there. Reach your right foot, right hand back. So we're reaching the right arm back, holding onto the left knee. Ugly dancer. Two more breaths. So it's like you're counterbalancing that left knee, left hand with the right arm reaching back. One more breath in and out. And then stepping back with the left foot, coming into a runner's lunge. So runner's lunge. Hands down, it can be on your fingertips. And then what I'd like you to do is take your hands behind your right hand behind your right ankle, right foot. And draw your head down towards the floor. You can take it this, so you can see from this way. We're trying to take our shoulder behind our knee, and then the right hand comes on the outside of the right foot. Draw your head down. Deep breaths. And from here, we're going to come into revolved Parsvatanasana. So take your knee down to start. Come up, take your hands to your heart center, and then hooking your left elbow across your right knee, pushing your chest to the side, so revolving your chest to the side, you're looking over your right shoulder. Take a deep breath in, push into the front foot, squeeze into the back thigh, lifting the leg off, and you're pushing your left heel away. Two more breaths. And then hands down. Step your feet together. Give your legs a little shake out. Draw yourself back up to standing. And then we're going to do our revolved triangle on the other side. So I'm going to turn around to face the other way so I don't have my back to you. So around to the other side now. Stepping your right foot back at a 45 degree angle. And remember, we're not centrally aligned with our feet. Our right foot is slightly out to the side. Send your hips forwards. So hands onto the hips. Reach your right arm forward. Outside of the left foot or onto a block there. If you need to take a block, if you can't reach down to the floor, then place a block on the outside edge of the left foot. Keeping that hand on the hip to start, squeeze the thighs towards each other, roll the left shoulder back. Open the chest to the side, and then lifting the left arm up to the sky. Squeeze your thighs towards each other, draw your right hip forwards and your left hip back. Scoop the belly in, so really squeeze into the waist. One more deep breath in and out. Look down to the front foot and then bring your arms parallel to the earth. Reach them in like. So take your weight into your left foot. Really push into the standing big toe. Finding your balance. Arms reaching out to the side. Squeeze into that standing leg. Reach the arms forwards, forwards, forwards. Three more breaths. Flex the foot, the lifted foot, and then into your standing split. So hands come down. Right hand supporting. Take your left hand to your ankle if you can. Drawing your head down towards your leg. Lift that right leg to the sky. Three more breaths. And then carefully without, if you can, taking your right foot to the floor. We're going to come up to standing nice and slowly. Take your right hand onto back, finding that counterbalance. Back the body, reaching back with the left arm. One to runner's lunge. So you can drop that right foot down, hands to the earth. Coming to a lovely runner's lunge. Step into a runner's lunge. And then bringing your shoulder behind your knee. The left hand on the outside of the foot. Draw your knee, your head down towards the earth. Squeeze into the thigh of the extended back leg. Take your hands onto the left hand around the left ankle if it feels comfortable. Bring yourself up so you can bring your hands to your heart center. Going to revolve over to the left. So hook the left onto the left knee with the right elbow. Bring your hands to your center. So you're revolving and spinning your chest. Look over your right shoulder. You can stay here or take it up a little notch, squeezing into that back leg thigh. Picking the heel, pushing that right heel away. Three more deep breaths. Ujjayi sounding breath in and out. And then take your hands down, knees down, take a little balasana. Just a couple of breaths. Nice deep inhale. Going to bring our right foot and leg forwards. Coming into half dove. So the foot can slide up. It doesn't have to be at a 90 degree angle. You can bring it as close or as far away from the body as you feel comfortable. Hips face forward. So you're not facing diagonally to the side. Your hips face forward and then folding down. Reach your arms forwards. Chest to land on that bent knee leg. Really stretch the fingertips forwards. A lovely stretch across the back, the upper back.
Three more breaths. Inhale, slide the hands back. Level with the knee. Push into the hands. Lift the chest up. Look up to the sky.
Tuck the back toes. Push into the hands really firmly so you can bring the right leg back and step the left leg forwards. Keeping the hips facing forwards, untuck the back toes. Deep breath in, then exhale. Folding down forwards over your front leg. Reach the arms forwards.
Try to press your armpits down towards the mat. Inhale
to come up, hands level with the front knee. Roll the shoulders back and down, open the chest. Feel openness in the front body. Slowly release. Coming down onto your bellies. Taking a little locust now. Keep the legs a little separated, so not together. Reach the arms forwards. On a breath in, we're going to lift our chest and legs and arms off as much as you can. Five breaths. Exhale, release down. And then we're going to open the arms wide to the side and do that same lift with the arms reaching sideways. So take a breath in, lift the legs, lift the chest. It's like you're skydiving. Five, four, three, two, one. Hands down. We're going to come into an elbow plank now. Elbows down, hands facing forwards, parallel with the forearms, or you can bring the hands together if it feels more comfortable for your shoulders. Tuck the toes and come into an elbow plank. I'm going to do 10 knee taps. Squeezing into the belly, tap the knees, light tap. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. Squeeze into the belly. Another couple. One more and hold. Five, four, three, two, one. Drop the hips down. Reach your hands for your ankles. Flex the feet. Squeeze the legs towards each other so that the thighs are parallel. Look down to the floor. Roll the shoulders back and down. Squeeze the shoulder blades together. Big breath in. Push your feet away. Pull your feet away. So you're pulling your hands into your feet into your hands. Five breaths, lift the feet and chest as much as you can. Four, three, two, and one. Knees down, push into the hands, coming into camel pose, Ustrasana next. For this, you can tuck the toes. You can also have blocks either side of your feet if you struggle to reach the heels. But first, we'll do a little prep. So hands, heels of the hands, the very low back. Drive the hips forward, squeeze into the thighs, into the glutes. Open the chest, so opening up the front body. Look up to the sky. Open the chest, squeeze the shoulder blades together. And release. A choice now to take the hands alongside the body. Take another five breaths like this, or reach for the heels or your blocks. Your choice. Drive those hips forwards. Look up to the sky if you can. Take care with the neck. Soften into the face. No strain. Three more breaths. And release into rabbit. So keeping your toes tucked, take hold of your heels and your feet with your hands. Take the crown of the head to the floor, as close to your knees as you can, and then take a nice deep inhale. So your chin will come in towards your chest, and you're lifting the hips up as high as you can, pulling onto the feet. You'll feel a stretch across the upper back. Scoop the belly up. A
deep breath in, exhale, release.
Coming into a child's pose for a couple of breaths.
And drop your hips to the left or the right so you can come onto your bottom. We're coming into boat, Navasana. So from here, keeping the legs parallel, hands behind the knees, tilting the body back, keeping the spine nice and straight. You can have a little play with this. We're going to do five variations, starting with the hands behind the knees. Five, four, scoop the belly in. Three, two, one, and release. Go back again, tilt back, and then extend the legs. Release the arms forwards. Five, four, three, two, a little shiver, a little shake, and release. And then we're going to take the arms alongside the ears with the legs extended. Keep with any version that you find works for you. Five, four, three, two, one. This one we're going to do five little twists side to side. Now keep your shins parallel to this. One, two, three, actually, okay, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Then from here, we're going to come into Ardha Navasana. Five, four, point your toes, chest lifts, gaze lifts. Three, two, one, hug your knees into chest. And then tucking your left leg in and your right leg behind, take a little twist to the right. Roll over onto the other side, little twist to the left. And then extend the legs forwards. Reach to the sky. Straight back. Tilt forward, reach forwards. Take the outsides of the feet. Big breath in, lift and lengthen. Exhale, fold down over the legs. Reach for a block beyond the feet if you have stretchy hamstrings today. Or if you need a strap, use a strap around the feet. Five deep breaths. Belly up, always engage into the abdominal area so that you're not actually using your arms to pull you forward. So use the strength of the abdominals to fold the body down and use the exhale to release and stretch into the backs of those legs. Squeeze into the thighs now, squeeze, 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 push the backs of the legs into the floor. Take a breath in, coming up. Bring your feet together. Together. If you're used to doing this off a block and you feel comfortable, then do so. But it's nice for tilting forwards. So lengthen the spine, open your feet like you're opening a book. So the hips open out, sending the chest forwards. Now elbows down to the floor as an option, palms facing up. We'll take the elbows down and prayer your hands, drop the head, and point your fingers down towards your back, down the back. Open the knees up. Five more breaths. Deep inhale, release.
Opening the legs. Uppavista Konasana. We're heading into the finishing straight now. So flexing the feet, legs nice and wide. Options to reach to the feet, dropping the head down to the floor. You can take your elbows down, palms facing up, or do that similar option we just did with the Baddha Konasana,
where you take your hands in prayer, elbows to the floor, reaching your hands down your back. Keep your legs fully engaged, flex you into your feet, so pull the toes in towards you. Five deep breaths. Inhaling, releasing,
slowly coming up Tilt back a little bit. Take your hands behind your knees. Oh, draw the legs in together. Give your legs a little shake. Rolling down onto your backs now into a little halasana. Actually, let's stretch into the back first. So rolling down nice and carefully onto your backs. Draw your right knee into your chest. Keep the left leg extended. Let's take a little twist. So dropping the right knee down to the left. You can push it down a little bit gently with the left hand. Reach your right hand to the side, palm facing up. Push your elbow, shoulder, arm into the floor. Don't let it lift. And send your gaze to the right hand. So we're twisting all the way up and down the spine. Deep breaths. Use the exhale to really release into these stretching postures. Two more breaths. Inhale to center. Swap legs. Extend the right leg. Hug the left knee in. Draw that left knee over to the right. Use the right hand on the outside of the knee. Just take note of any difference, left side, right side. Keep the arm and shoulder of the left arm completely glued to the floor. Look to your left hand. Palm facing up. Use the exhale to stretch that little bit further each breath out. You might notice one knee goes over further than the other. That's quite normal, quite asymmetrical in the hips and pelvis often. Or you just have one tight side. Inhale to center, hug the knees to chest. Give it a lovely hug in, little rock side to side. And then coming into plow. So hands down, palms to the floor, rolling up onto your shoulders. Do not turn your head from side to side. Knees onto the forehead to start. You can clasp the elbows, hands together, elbows down, away from you, and then extend the legs, squeeze into the thighs. Some stuff behind me there, should you move to the side? Squeeze into the thighs, so you're lifting the thighs away from your face, if you're on your toes. You can close your eyes, keep your focus, attention inwards. Coming up into shoulder stand. Now, if you're very accustomed to doing it this way, you can actually keep your hands clasped like this. Make sure your head does not turn from side to side, and you can lift your legs up to the sky. So you're balancing on your arms outstretched behind you, or take your hands to support your lower back. Keep your head static. Do not turn it from side to side. So using the support method, or extending and reaching the arms away. Squeeze the elbows towards each other. 10 breaths. Draw navel to spine. Squeeze into your Mula Bandha as well. Pelvic floor, squeeze it in. If this feels uncomfortable for you, then come into Viparita Karani. That L-shaped position, legs extended up to the sky with your back down. Coming out slowly, fire a plow. So drop the legs down towards the face, point the toes, extend the arms now and clasp the hands, palms facing down. Use your arms and hands as brakes and engage into the belly, the abdominals to lower the legs down with control. Bring your hands close together so that your bottom lands onto the tops of your hands. Into fish, Matsyasana. So legs point away down to the floor. Push into the elbows, lift the chest up, open the chest, and then gently crown the head drops down to the floor. Deep belly breaths. Feel the rise and fall of your belly. Into Uttana Padmasana if that's your practice. So releasing the hands from under the bottom, reach the hands to the sky in Atmanjali Mudra. Lifting the legs up, squeeze into the thighs. 5, 4, 3, squeeze into the abdominals. 2, 1, lower the legs down. Arms wide, lift the head, look to your feet. Draw your feet in, let's window wipe our legs. From side to side and roll the head from side to side. Pop on any jumpers, socks, things you need for your relaxation. Ways to relax can be with the knees bent, pushing the lower back into the floor, a little tilt in the pelvis. If you're having any lower back discomfort. You can extend the legs. You can pop a block or a cushion or two in the backs of the knees. If you have any knee issues, that just also helps to relax into the legs a little bit. You can also take your feet together and take Supta Baddha Konasana. Your options. All there for you to choose from, yogi choice. Closing the eyes. Let's take a few moments to fully relax the body. You've worked hard today, you've raised your vibrational energy in your bodies. Now it's time to enjoy that energy flowing through your body, through your cells, through the meridian channels in your body. Let's connect intimately with the body and how it feels, without judgment, without any criticism. Remaining in this present moment, relaxing your face. Relax the muscles of your face. Unclench your jaw. Allow the tongue to rest heavy in its mouth, in the mouth, and the eyes to rest deeply in their sockets. So smooth out the face, the brow, the cheeks, the jaw. Relaxing into the neck and the throat. Soften there. Allow the breath to simply flow naturally in and out. No longer forcing, just let it flow. Allow your arms, shoulders, and hands to sink into the floor. Circle your attention around your chest. Feeling your heart beating, your chest expanding, rising and falling on the breath in and out. And then thinking of love and gratitude. Thinking of your gratitude practice, the things you are grateful for, let them expand and fill you up. Feeling love, love has the greatest resonance and vibration of all emotions. Remember, energy follows thought. So fill your heart, fill your soul, fill your spirit with love and gratitude. Relaxing into your chest, your upper back, your abdomen and lower back. The whole torso softening into the floor. Fully letting go. Circling your attention into the hips, buttocks, pelvic area. Releasing, softening. Dissolving any tension there, letting go. Breathe into that area. Softening into the thighs and hamstrings, the fronts of the knees, the backs of the knees, down to the shins and calves, flowing down to your ankles, tops of the feet, the soles of the feet, the heels and the 10 toes. And kindly scanning your whole body with love and compassion. Giving some love and gratitude to yourself for your practice, for your body, the miracle of life that flows through it. And if you wish, take your attention to your intention. Maybe reaffirm it now, either saying it out loud or speaking silently to your inner mind's eye. Slowly wiggling your fingers and toes. Bring your legs together or stretch your legs out if you were in Supta Baddha Konasana. Reach your arms overhead. Give yourself a glorious stretch. Keep your eyes closed for the moment. Take a nice deep breath in through the nose. Fill the lungs up, open the mouth and sigh the breath out. Rolling over onto your right side and then slowly coming up to a seated cross-legged position. Keeping the gaze low or the eyes closed. come back to cross-legged seated position, or if you feel more comfortable than coming into Virasana, hero's pose. Keeping the spine long and tall, the crown of the head reaching to the sky, chin towards the chest. Bringing your hands together, rub them together. Energize your hands. And then take your hands slightly apart and imagine an energy ball here. Bring it down to your heart center. Imagine a ball of energy spinning, brightly white energy, bright white energy. Your energy and that of the universe. And then drawing your hands together, unifying left side, right side, bring it to your heart. Gently lowering your head down towards your fingertips. With great gratitude and love and peace. Peace, peace, peace. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Namaste. Thank you, friends, for your practice today. I hope you feel energized yet calm at the same time. And I look forward to seeing you here again soon. Next practice, Friday morning, 9:30. We're going to work on the hips. So we're going to do some hip opening. And some vinyasa flow then too. Have a wonderful, wonderful Wednesday. Take care. Have a lovely, blessed day. God bless. Bye.